Do you think Alina Habba is trying to become Trump's AG should he win? What damage could she cause? All of it. Like, literally, if you can picture any damage that an attorney general of the United States could do, Alina Habba would do it. In my opinion, and again, this is just my opinion that I am fully entitled to, by the way, I think Alina Habba is the dumbest lawyer I've ever seen in my life. And I've worked at a law firm, by the way, for almost 20 years. I've seen some great ones come through, and I've seen some really, really bad ones that just simply could not cut it. But I have never seen anyone, in my opinion, as grossly incompetent as Alina Habba has proven herself to be repeatedly. I mean, look at the fraud trial. Day one, the judge has to come out and be like, hey, by the way, the reason we don't have a jury trial here is because she messed up. Like, she, her, Alina Habba. And she went on the media later and told Trump, she's like, oh, that's not true. I didn't do that. The judge literally said you did. That's like the one person in court that definitely cannot lie. So you can argue the point all you want. You're bad at it. Not to mention the fact that Donald Trump knows she's bad at this. That's why she got pulled off of the other trials and demoted to being a spokesperson for his super PAC. You don't do that with somebody that has a brilliant legal mind. So as attorney general, if that is something Trump would be considering, she would be the worst of the worst we've ever had. Luckily, however, I don't think Trump would consider that. If he does win the White House, would Alina Habba have a spot in the White House? 100%. She could be White House counselor. I mean, she could basically, and I think this is probably more likely than her being AG, is I think she would probably take over the role that Kellyanne Conway had, right? So you're the counselor. You offer, you know, advice on things here and there. But for the most part, you're just kind of going out there, putting your face in the media and running interference and spreading propaganda. That's what Alina Habba does as a spokesperson for Trump's super PAC. So I believe she would just carry that role over into his administration should he win office. But either way, if Trump is still around, Alina Habba is still going to be around. And she's kind of banking on that too. Like, she has staked her entire reputation on Donald Trump not going anywhere. So if he goes to jail, you're not going to be hearing the name Alina Habba anymore. Like, she is going to fade off into obscurity, and trust me, that cannot happen fast enough. But if Trump somehow escapes liability, you know, escapes conviction in all of these 91 felony charges he's facing, if he somehow wins the White House, then we're going to have to deal with Alina Habba probably every day for 4 straight years. And that, to me, is a horrifying thought.